Her Excellency, Minister of Environment and Forestry, Republic of Indonesia, Ibu Dr. Siti Nurbaya. Her Excellency, Madam Ale Sudarnono, Minister of Tourism and Environment, Republic of Congo. Mr. Jose Ilana Lovona, Forest General Director and Personal Representative, Ministry of Environment and Sustainable Development, Democratic Republic of Congo. Mr. Eric Sobe, Executive Director of the Environment. Dr. Robert Nasi, Director General of CIFOR. Honorable Representative of Governments, Distinguished Guests, Ladies and Gentlemen. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning to all of you. Allow me to start by extending my sincere gratitude to the Minister of Republic of Congo, Representative of the Minister of Democratic Republic of Congo, UN Environment, CIFOR, FAO, and the delegation. Welcome to Indonesia. In this opportunity, I would like to briefly highlight Indonesian efforts to achieve the sustainable management of tropical peatland that will be setting an international tropical peatland center with shortly to launch. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, Indonesia has gained extensive knowledge on peatland management through experiences, research and development, and institutional arrangements. In the past, Indonesian people have traditionally utilized peatland for their livelihood, but some unsustainable management of peatland have also been experienced by Indonesia during timber boom and agricultural expansion era. These experiences have led Indonesia to focus on the conservation and sustainable management of its peatland. Comprehensive actions have been taken by the Indonesian government, including policy and regulation, establishing a special agency for peat restoration, and coordinating actions with all levels of government and stakeholders. Policies, regulations, law enforcement, and institutional arrangements in improving management of Indonesian peatland have dramatically reduced the degradation of peatland and peat fire events. This also reflects a better governance of Indonesian peatlands that can ensure protection of good peatland areas from degradation and stop the degraded peatland from further damage. Indonesia does not only work by itself to mitigate problems in relation to peat sustainable management. Indonesia also communicates and collaborates with other countries and international agencies to manage tropical peatland for sustainable use. Many international initiatives used to save peatlands, the largest terrestrial organic soil carbon stock, which contain almost 100 times more carbon than tropical forests. The initiation seeks to mobilize governments, international organizations, and academia in an effort to protect peatlands. Conventions, agreements, tractates, and more have been become a binding commitment of countries or parties to save the peat. Such convention on climate change, convention on desertification, and convention on biodiversity. Also, many initiatives already show up their role, such as Global Peatland Initiative, Global Landscape Forum, International Peatland Society, and more. In the Southeast Asia region, as the ASEAN member, Indonesia has ratified the ASEAN Agreement on Transboundary Hazard Pollution to prevent and control cross-border smoke pollution as a result of land and or forest fire, particularly in peatlands that must be implemented through intensive national, regional, and international efforts based on commitment, spirit of partnership, and a tradition of solidarity to achieve peace, progress, and prosperity among ASEAN countries. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, to the day, the government of Indonesia brought an inspiring story of successful peatland management, which it had to the chance to present up on the world stage. The success management is now becoming an inspiring experience, which later other countries to learn about. This is also highlighted on the FAO co-committee to deliver Indonesia commitment of corrective action to manage peatland sustainability. Respectively, establishing an international tropical peatland center or ITPC in the global is essential at this point in time to develop interdisciplinary and integrated actions for development focused on peatland, to build capacity of human resources in managing peatlands and to collaborate with partners. It presents to use a new international tropical peatland center to be based in Indonesia. At this point in time, there is a past establishment in the global south. So, aims to support countries with the management of tropical peatland in sustainable way. Second, they build the capacity of human resources in managing peatlands. Third, promote multi-stakeholder cooperation on tropical peatland management, including peatland-based industries. And fourth, develop interdisciplinary and integrated research for development, focused on advancing sustainable management. In the spirit of international multi-stakeholder and social cooperation, the ITPC is to be built on the principle of true cross-sector collaboration and integration, building a resilient and holistic platform for science, policy, and practice, and attracting the best minds working on research and practice. It is expected that the ITPC will take the role of key global science and knowledge platform for tropical peatlands, involving relevant stakeholders, governments, international organizations, universities and researchers, the private sectors, civil society, community, funding partners, and financial aid. To prepare for the operationalization of the ITPC, there will be an Ad Interim Secretariat to be based in Bogor, in Indonesia, which is on this morning in the soft launch marked by the signing of the joint declaration. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, since 22nd October 2018, we, the Republic of Indonesia, Republic Democratic of Congo, the Republic of Congo, have toured to the peat field in West Kalimantan, also in Fordia campus and CIFOR campus. This delighted day, 13 October 2018, we meet here to update 20 opportunities that will be shared on the following three panel discussion will be as follows. First, high-level panel discussion. Second, panel discussion on best practices for Indonesian peatland. The third, panel discussion on international collaboration and experience in peatland. Ladies, Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, finally, I would like to invite Her Excellency Minister Siti Nurbaya to deliver the recent remarks and inaugurate the ITPC Interim Secretariat, also declare the ITPC start to run shortly. Before that, I would like to invite the Madam Minister Alec from the Republic of Congo, and also Mr. Ryan Sohin to deliver the remarks. Thank you very much for your kind attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.